Push her over.
What a dumb girl. That's why women are...
Yeah, run, bitch!
What are you gonna do now, huh?
Who's greasy now, huh? Who's greasy now?
So it can be hard for young people to figure out what's okay and what's not okay when they see those messages around them all the time. There's a lot of violence portrayed in the media, and that's seen really as normal in relationships.
Oh, just another lonely night. Are you willing to sacrifice your life?
Chum a monster, no good blood sucker.
We see this kind of thing all the time. We know it's not real, and that it's just TV and movies, but it keeps coming back to us. It starts to feel like violence isn't that big of a deal. How do we know where the line is?
Verbal abuse and emotional abuse, though they often happen earlier in a relationship before physical violence, it's also important to realize that those are violence in and of themselves.
My first relationship was in eighth grade. I met a girl on the first day of school. 2 weeks later, I asked her out. 5 days into the relationship, she told me she loved me. It was my first relationship, so I thought, you know, whatever, maybe it's normal, I'll let it slide. But then she started texting me all the time, and calling me all the time, and being next to me all the time, and when she wasn't with me, she'd be asking why I wasn't with her, and if I was with someone else, she'd ask me why I was with them and not her, or if I was cheating on her. And she said some very nasty things to other people about me, because she thought I hated her, or some crazy conspiracy of the sort. And I realized that she wasn't meant for me when I went to a party and I went to help my friend get on a costume and she told me that I had been cheating on her the whole time. That's when I realized I needed to get out of that.
The relationship was great at first, but pretty soon it became apparent that every time we saw anything that had anything to do with my faith, he would just say things like, I hate Christians. Christians are stupid. Christians just shouldn't be even around. Or, you know how I feel about that.
People tell me that the verbal and the emotional behaviors that happen can sometimes even have a longer lasting effect than getting hit. They can feel worse than the physical violence.
It's the meanest anyone has ever been to me, and I have never been as hurt or as offended or as angry as when I was with him.
Because most people who act abusively, they want to gain power, and they want to be in a position of power in the relationship. But in a healthy relationship, power is shared equally between the two people.
I won't say mean things.
Here's a sit in your seat! See my girl Sam? She's the sneakiest bitch you'll ever meet!
Dallas, one of these days, pow, right there!
It's easiest to get out of an unhealthy or an abusive relationship early on when some of those signs are just starting.
Your partner is controlling about where you go or who you talk to.
He keeps calling or texting you even when you've asked him to stop.
She has rules instead of just talking with you about what would work best for both of you.
There's a lot of yelling.
Your partner doesn't respect the time you want to spend with your friends.
If you are tense and unhappy most of the time.
A disrespectful relationship is like
when one of them just abuse each other or something, you know, and don't really care for them, don't stand up for them when they're getting put down by family or other people. Yeah.
Lucy, if you're gonna act like a child, I'm gonna have to treat you like one.
Meaning what?
Meaning I'll put you over my knees and
I'll... You wouldn't dare!
Oh, I would.
No, you wouldn't! Help me!
No, you can't. You wanna fight? I'm a man, honey. It's no contest. You have to understand, Slim, and I thought you did. I make the money here, so I set the rules, right?
Relationship violence is not just a problem for women or girls to talk about. It's really important that we get boys and men involved in talking about it, too. And women are not the only victims of violence. Men can be victims of violence. Women can be abusive. And violence happens in heterosexual relationships, and it also happens in same-sex relationships. With both genders, so it's a problem that affects everybody.
At the end of the day, you're all human, and women's hits hurt too. I have seen some women do some serious damage. I have done some serious damage. So it's like, I don't know, if someone abuses you, or if someone were to abuse me, my thing would be to get out of that relationship immediately. Like, we are done. Whether it's just like an angry shove or like just anything abusive, whether it's verbal, mental, whatever, I can't do that. You will not treat me like anything less than what I need to be treated like, or anything less than how I'm treating you.
A bad relationship feels like like you can't trust the person, even though when you put trust in them, they don't put trust back to you. It just feels like you're lonely, you have no one to talk to.
If we look around, the media gives us all these examples of bad relationships being normal. But feeling bad isn't normal.
Violence should not be a normal part of our lives. And we might experience it, we all see it around us, but that doesn't mean that that's the way things should be.
Obviously, the media is not teaching us about good relationships. Let's agree on that. What are the other ways we can learn?
I learned to have a respectful relationship from my parents. I've seen them do plenty of horrible things in their relationship, and then I've seen them in new relationships that are obviously a lot better.
I learned by watching my sister and my brothers and them. I learned from my family, my cousins. Recently, my cousins just got married. They treat each other well. They have respect for each other. They have trust. Sometimes they argue, but then, you know, you have to make it up. Yeah.
A partner should not put you down, and a friend should remind you how great you are.
You're a really talented musician.
Thanks, Francis.
Casey, I like that you defend your, you have a really strong belief in yourself, and you defend your beliefs always.
Thank you so much, Leah.
Mm-hmm. You're very, you know, strong. You're kind of like Superwoman in my eyes.
Teens might not realize that they deserve a respectful dating relationship unless somebody tells them. Everybody know I'm a monster.
I'ma need to see a pee of hands at the concert. I'ma need to see a pee of hands at the concert. Okay, Kanye, enough. We got your shock video and we don't want that.
The way I want to be treated in a respectful relationship is to for them to respect my space, and I will respect theirs too. Unless like we know each other really well, but then if I just met you like a month ago or like a week ago, I would expect my space too.
I would say a respectful relationship is when the two persons in love, they have trust, they have good communications, but not every relationship is all that. You have to have patience and just help guide your partner, girlfriend, or boyfriend. Just guide them through their problems, comfort them, and just be loving and caring.
That was kind of cheesy, but it's more of what we want in a relationship.
It takes time to actually love someone, and I think it's like the best thing in the world. It's like the best feeling in the world, actually.
So just as violence can spread, nonviolence can spread too.
It's a ripple effect. The way we treat each other in our intimate relationships is ultimately reflected in our society. If we treat each other poorly in our relationships, that's going to show up in our community. But if we treat each other with kindness and respect, then maybe on a larger scale, that will help people treat each other better.
We see many bad relationships in the media,
but we know better.
So the media had better follow our lead.
Because we're making this change. Woo! Woo!